Hello! Today I've got a blacklight alien for you. And yeah, also I have a new way of actually doing these sort of videos, like the blacklight videos. I used to do them in a way, if you've watched them before, obviously you know, but in case you haven't, I'll just tell you now. I used to do them in normal light, just because it was easier for me to see and easier to film. And then to show the actual blacklight effect at the end and the beginning, but I don't know, I think it's just a bit less interesting to watch for you guys. So yeah, and also more importantly, actually a photographer told me that the tripods that I use for my filming lamps can actually go up way higher than I thought they could. I had no idea. I'm definitely not smart with like technical stuff. But yeah, like with my former camera, it took me about 2 years to find out it could autofocus while filming. Quite bad, yeah. Either way, yeah, so with this lamp, it's a matter of, like, there's two clasps in the middle and you can just shove it upwards. So now I have it so that my blacklight lamp is actually right above my camera, so it's still close enough to my face that I can actually, like, show you the blacklight. I don't have a very strong lamp, so it needs to be quite close to me without me having to physically hold it. So, yeah, that's why this entire tutorial will actually be in blacklight, so I hope you like it. Yeah, the inspiration was sort of an alien, by the way. I just really had fun with it, so yeah, let's get started. So the only product I actually use for this look is the Crayolan Aqua Color Palette in Dayglow. The Dayglow Palette, really. Which is obviously blacklight paint, but it's water-based, so, you know, you activate it with water, but you can also wash it off with water, which is quite nice. Like, there's also, like, I don't even know actually if there's alcohol-based palettes in blacklight. I really have no idea, but either way, I always pick the water-based one because I want it to be easy to remove. And what I started out with is just sort of an eyeliner. And then I also did sort of a wing on the bottom. Like, I wanted alien eyes, but I really wanted the eyes to be sort of fierce and stand out. So I picked the absolute brightest shade in the palette for that. And just did two layers, actually. Like, I let it dry, then added another layer that works very well with this sort of paint. Because then it just gets more opaque and more glowy. And do be careful around your eyes, of course. Like, I've had this stuff in my eyeballs before and it didn't do any damage, but still, I don't particularly recommend it. Then on my forehead, I decided to do swirls and completely disregard my eyebrows. Mine are sort of visible, but not very. If you have darker eyebrows, you could always just, beforehand, obviously, cover them with scar wax, FX wax, and then some powder and then foundation to make sure they stand out less, or concealer, whatever you prefer. But yeah, I just completely ignored mine because they're not very obvious anyway. I'm a natural blonde, so that helps. Yeah, then I also did sort of a nose contour with it. I wanted it to keep it sort of human-esque, but different, I suppose. And then I just also made some dots on the forehead. Just pressing the brush on top of it and then just sort of wiggling it to get a circle. I decided to do my lips in green, and sorry, by the way, if the, it was sort of hard to get this camera settings right, so for some reason, throughout the first part of this video, my camera kept going darker and darker the more paint it would apply. I don't know, I've actually taken a photo with my phone of my camera settings at the end, so I know how to start next time. But yeah, it will get lighter in a little bit, but for now, this is what we gotta work with. But yeah. I just filled in my lips with green and sort of made a creepy grin of it, because I felt like doing a creepy grin. And then I also added sort of a blush with the pink face paint. And here the camera settings were finally okay. Yeah, I was seriously fumbling with that for like half an hour. But yeah, either way, I just used a nail art brush actually for that, a fan brush, a very thin one. And then just with the brush, only a little bit damp, I blended it out. So it sort of really turned into a blush rather than just, you know, a pink streak. I didn't want it to be completely smooth. Yes, this was my attempt at looking cute. I failed, I know. Yep. But yeah, I didn't want it to be completely smooth because I still wanted it to be sort of like alien skin and not, you know, normal smooth human skin. I did the same thing on my chin and on my forehead. Then I added some lashes in blue and purple, which are the colors of the palette that stand out the least, but they actually on camera stand out way more, so I'm happy about that. And I also added gills, maybe. Not sure what I was trying to make these look like, but I don't know, I just wanted to add some detail there as well, just to fill up my face completely. And then I added some more highlights. I just wanted it to be more highlighted, pretty much.
Just the exact same thing as it did with the pink, only a little bit less and in yellow instead of in pink. So yeah, especially at my nose, I was very, very, very careful with blending this out because obviously I didn't want to go over the pink lines and erase them or mix them with yellow and then having to redo it all. On my cheeks, it also blended out nicely. Like, it didn't remove the pink, it just very nicely blended with it, like an actual highlight would with a blush. Also added a little bit on my upper lip or above it. And sort of blended out my jawline to make it a little bit more, I don't know. It looked better in my opinion. And yeah, then here is the final result. I had a lot of fun doing this. I'm definitely going to play more with the camera settings to do it even better in the future. I hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did like it, please click the like button. And if you want to, you can always subscribe to my channel. For now, thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Bye!